Sports, Filipino boxer Jerry Nangkaha seeks to redeem his IBF Super Flyweight title at this weekend's rematch with his Argentinian foe Fernando Martinez. Steve Angelus has the details.
Looking to regain what was once his, former IBF Super Flyweight champion Jerwin Ancajas faced off with Argentina's Fernando Martinez ahead of their October 8th world title rematch. Last February, the Argentinian Olympian outclassed the heavily favored Ancajas.
Nagpapasalamat po ako sa Panginoon, sir, kasi ito, binigyan ulit ako ng pagkakataon na makalaban sa World Championship. At ito ngayon, masaya kami sa team kasi nakuha namin yung gusto namin kunin na kondisyon sa pagtitraining, sa pagdadiet namin. Hindi katulad nung laban namin last time ni Martinez.
While Ancajas' conditioning was blamed for the loss, he says he's better prepared against the Puma, who has a 14-win and no-loss record.
Sa ngayon po, prepared na kami sa anumang igalaw ni Martinez po sa laban na to. Kasi alam naman namin pareho na yung galaw, sir.
Martinez's victory snapped Ancajas' 10-year, 21-fight unbeaten streak. Martinez admits defending the title will be no easy task, especially against the man he took it from.
Hola, muy buenas tardes.
You bet it's going to be hard, but being the champion has given me an added sense of responsibility that I take with a lot of humility, and I'm trying to keep my feet firmly on the ground, be focused on the fight, and I know that I want to make Argentinian people happy.
The Ancajas Martinez world title rematch fight kicks off the Sebastian Fandura versus Carlos Ocampo Showtime telecast, taking place in Carson's Dignity Health Sports Park from 7 p.m.
The pretty boy won't be the only Filipino fighting on Saturday night. Olympic hero Yumir Marshall also has a scheduled six-round middleweight clash against American Steven Pichardo. Steve Angelus, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
A crime thriller, a sci-fi, and a coming-of-age film. Our resident movie critic Manny the Movie Guy tells us what he thinks of three new flicks hitting the screen soon.
Christian Bale's doctor, Margot Robbie's nurse, and John David Washington's lawyer are the prime suspects in this 1930s set murder mystery from writer-director David O. Russell of American Hustle and Silver Linings Playbook fame. The stars gave them all, even though the film can't decide if it's a screwball comedy or a crime thriller. The confused tone of the script led to misguided direction that squandered the talent of the great cast, who nearly saved the film. If you love great chemistry with good production and custom design, then Amsterdam is for you. But in the end, Amsterdam, for all its posturings, is just a tad bit hollow. And for that, Amsterdam gets 2.5 out of 4, only in theaters, Kisses. Also out in theaters, Lyle Lyle Crocodile.
It's just like a big clumsy animal.
Based on Lyle the Crocodile series of books by Bernard Weber, pop star Shawn Mendes is the voice of Lyle, a saltwater crocodile who cannot talk but can sing.
Music is his language.
The cast is charming, with Javier Bardem as a hack magician who discovers Lyle in an exotic pet shop. Some actors sing off-key, and that's all right. They may lack talent in the singing department, but they provide the heart of the film.
We have a crocodile living in our attic.
From directors Will Speck and Josh Gordon, the guys who gave us Blades of Glory, Lyle Lyle Crocodile is all harmless fun for the entire family. I would have loved more bite from the film, but it's colorful and whimsical enough that I'm giving it 3 out of 4 After a While Crocodile Kisses. And streaming on Amazon Prime Video is my pick of the week, Catherine Called Birdie. All hail Lena Dunham! The girl's creator went medieval on us in this heartfelt and joyful adaptation of Karen Cushman's novel.
Some say she has a third ear.
Bella Ramsey is fantastic as Lady Catherine, a clever and adventurous teenager who loves birds, but she has one big problem. Her family is desperate to marry her off.
How did you piss as creatures?
Funny, sweet, and very smart, Catherine Called Birdie will lift your spirits. This is a rare coming-of-age movie that will make you laugh and cry while empowering the young generation.
Birdie spoke to me, so a big congrats.
And for that, Catherine called Birdie gets 3.5 out of 4. Stream it now on Amazon Prime Video. Kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.
Telling your own story.